Today on the show, I'm going to talk to you guys about one of my three key principles in networking, and that's to show up and say and do what you say you're going to do. And I'm going to tell you a powerful story about my first interview with a real estate broker that didn't do that and how it cost him hundreds of thousands of dollars. So I wanted to take you guys, this is the building where when I first got into real estate, I interviewed with three brokerages. One was a family friend, one was just a random company that I'd heard a little bit about, wanted to check out, and the third one was a REMAX, and I love REMAX, love everything about REMAX, but I'm going to tell you why I didn't end up at REMAX. This is such a crazy story. I really thought that's where I was going to end up. I kind of liked the idea, the colors, and they just at that time seemed like the biggest company to me. It was right before, you know, when they were kind of the biggest company in town or whatever. And I went and I interviewed with these three different companies. The first one was a family friend, went fine. He didn't really know what he was doing, but at the same time it was new, it was kind of fun. I kind of liked the idea of being with somebody I already was familiar with. The second one was Exit Realty. And I remember the broker when I interviewed with him, he had a little stain on his shirt and it just bothered me. It was like a mustard stain. I remember thinking to myself, like, this guy's kind of a slob. His shirt was kind of like the thread was coming out, and I just remember thinking to myself, like, it's not what I want. So I was really pretty sure I was going to end up at REMAX. And I go and I interview with the agent, with the broker. This broker had spoken, he'd come and he trained at the real estate school when I was getting my license. So I was a little familiar with him and I was impressed by him. He was a former college football player at the university I cheer for. And I really had liked the guy when I heard him speak. So I went into his brokerage and I sat down. Keep in mind, I'm a brand new agent. He doesn't know about what's going to happen. But to give you guys an idea, my first full year as a real estate agent, I sold 60 homes. Year two, I sold 98 homes. So my first 2 years as an agent, you can imagine, even if he was only getting, you know, 5% of that as a REMAX broker, plus my monthly fees, everything else goes into that, it cost him a couple hundred thousand dollars because I didn't end up at REMAX. And what happened when I showed up at this building, this is where the office was, not even here anymore. I haven't heard his name forever. I don't even know if he's still around. But when I came in and interviewed with him, and this is again one of the three key things, anything that every time I speak about networking, I train people on how the best way to network, one of those three things is you have to show up and do what you say you're going to do. Well, in this case, this particular broker, I sat down, I don't remember anything else from the interview. He walked through the structure and the pay and all that. But the thing I remembered most is he said, "Listen, Jimmy, I'll commit to you one thing as your broker. If you ever call me or email me, then even if I miss your call, leave me a message. I'll always get back to you before the night's done. I never end my day before I answer all those emails and all those calls." And so I remember I went home that night and I was excited. I was like, okay, I'm gonna go with REMAX. And so I decided this is the guy, this is who I'm gonna go with. So I give him a call. I left him a message. I said, "Hey Bob, this is Jimmy Rex. Talked to you earlier today. Give me a call as soon as you can. Pretty excited about talking to you about coming into the brokerage." The guy didn't call me back. It was the one thing he said he was going to do when I left his office. He said, "No matter what, I always return that call." And he didn't do it. And I just remember thinking to myself, like, this is so stupid. This guy promised one thing and didn't pull through on it. And so I decided to go with the family friend instead. And the rest is history, like I said. But he called me the next day and he said, "Hey, sorry I didn't get back to you, blah, blah, blah." Came up with all these reasons why I didn't get back to him. I said, "Dude, you said no matter what, you'd get back to me. And I just honestly can't depend upon you now." And so in business and in real estate especially, like, so many times we do this, like, we say we're going to do something, we don't do it, and then we get mad at our client because they're bugged at us. But the truth is if you just show up and do the things you say you're going to do, you're going to open up more doors than anything else that you ever do. I'll give you one quick example. A lot of you guys know that I've worked undercover and done a lot of work with Operation Underground Railroad. I've had the opportunity to work undercover with Tony Robbins and to go do things with the Pittsburgh Steelers head coach Mike Tomlin. I've been able to meet Glenn Beck and all these amazing humans, Tim Ballard, and work firsthand on over 11 different undercover operations. And a lot of people know the story how I got to work with them. But long story short, when I first heard Paul Hutchinson, he's a guy that runs a $13 billion fund here in Utah, speak about going undercover with OUR, I was so impressed. I went up to him afterwards. I said, "Hey, I want to be a part of this organization." And he said, "Well, there's a lot of people that want to help us. We've got over 400 people in line that, you know, ex-military, police, and special forces, all these things." I said, "Yeah, but I want to do it. Like, I'm not going away. Like, I want to do this. Like, this is something I'm committed to do." And he said, "Well," he kind of blew me off. He told me later he was trying to get rid of me, but he said, "Well, there's this big event on Saturday next week. It's a fundraiser. It's $5,000 per table. If you're serious about this, you should get a table." I said, "Great. Put me down for a table." So I showed up, we go to that, and then everything he asked me to do, I just kept doing it, just kept showing up. And it was pretty funny because what happened, eventually he just said, this is a guy I know I can count on. And once he's one of my closest friends in the world now, this Paul, and he told me, he said, Jimmy, the one thing I knew about you is that no matter what I asked you to do, I knew I could count on you. And he goes, you don't know how rare that is in this world. So many times people would come to me and they'd ask to be part of OUR. They'd ask to be part of my business, you know, this huge real estate fund that he had formed. He said, people just fall away when you actually give them chores, or they just don't do what they say they're going to do. He goes, you just always overperformed. Everything I asked you to do, you overdid it, and I just wanted you around. And so anyways, what I learned from that was just, we think this is like something that just should be obvious, right? If you say you're going to do something, follow up with it. But it really isn't. And in our industry especially, it's important. When you say you're going to do something, if you say you're going to call someone back, if you say you're going to call someone the next day, if you say you're going to call every Friday with an update on their house, you've got to follow through with what you say you're going to do. And people notice these things. It'll open doors for you that you couldn't open ever any other way.